Thanks. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Go away. By the way, Governor Huckabee said that he'd bail me out if I got arrested for that, so. This is insane. Cannot America see the hypocrisy and the stupidity of all this? You're being lied to, and we are finished with your tyranny, and we are going to enjoy Thanksgiving, and we're going to worship God. Open your churches. Go back to church. Open businesses. Take off the mask.
We don't know where this is going, but I believe this is actually unacceptable by whatever standards that is being carried out by for months now. California churches have been fighting in the courts to be allowed to reopen and exercise their religious freedom. And at the same time, we are having the state are insisting that churches have to be locked. So on the other hand, the churches are defying the state shutdown orders and they are continuing with their services. Of course, famous among these has been MacArthur, who has been there from day one. Now what's amazing is that whereas the religious freedoms are being clamped down, we are finding that abortion businesses that kill unborn babies and now strip clubs are being allowed to operate. And they are arguing that shutting down strip clubs would be more beneficial to the government than closing them down. I don't know where that is coming from. I don't know what kind of constitution they are reading or if it's being misinterpreted. But there's such a big problem where the state cannot force strip clubs to be closed, but they can harass the church to remain closed and observe social distancing and wearing the masks and all over, whereas the strippers don't have to wear masks. They can strip off everything, even to dancing in the nude, but they will not spread the disease. But with the worshippers come in their masks, perhaps they will infect each other. It's interesting that live adult entertainment businesses are part of the COVID hypocrisy report. Well, this is becoming unacceptable, especially to the churches, because it's as if the Democrats really don't care and they don't have a place for religious freedom, and they hate. When they say hate, it means complete hatred, whereby they don't regard God or the church whatsoever. If you are going to accept the argument that dancing in the nude is protected speech, then it's interesting that the government would bow to the pressure of nude clubs insofar as COVID-19 orders and the regulation of citizen is concerned, and then obviously denying divine worship of God, which is expressly mentioned in the First Amendment in the Constitution of the United States. The pro-life legal groups represent several California churches that are suing the state for violating their religious freedom. And we are yet to see where this one will get to. Of course, the churches are not ready to give up. They are not giving up. They have dug in their heels. And as you can see at Calvary Chapel, the pastor is making a mockery of their hypocrisy thereby. And we need to stand for what we believe is right. And that's where Peter said, it is to be seen whether we will obey God or we will obey man. This is where now the government usually comes across as bullying those who cannot accept being bullied. There are some people, when you step on their toes, and especially or in regards to the worship, then this cannot be accepted whatsoever. So this battle between the state and the church, it seems, will continue. And of course, you know where the Democrats stand. They completely disregard and disrespect religious freedom, and whereas they are opening the church, opening the strip clubs and the abortion clinics, and then giving an excuse as to why they are opening them, while also giving crazy excuses why the churches should remain closed, then this is a complete open and shut case of an hypocrisy that is being perpetuated, where COVID-19 becomes the official excuse of shutting the churches down.